Today's class I am going to teach about how to write the test bench Verilog HDL code for 1:4 demultiplexer. So previous video we discussed the normal Verilog HDL code and concept of 1:4 demux. If you need it, kindly refer the video. So in this 1:4 demux, we have two inputs. So D in and selection line. So these two variable consider as a input variable. Then A comma B comma C comma D is the output variable. In test bench Verilog HDL code, the input variable is declared as register, output variable declared as wire. So it's a basic concept. So now I am going to write the Verilog HDL code. So first I write module, then module name. So module name is test. So it's a module name. Then declaration of input variables. So rich D in. So it's a input variable. Then rich 1:0 selection. So the selection line is a vector format 1:0. So this selection line is two variable S1 and S0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. If selection line S0 and S1 is 0, 0, so output A is connect to input. So this D in is connect to output A. Suppose 0, 1, so B equal to D in. 1, 0, C equal to D in. 1, 1, D equal to D in. So it's a selection line. So this selection line is a two variable. So here I am using vector format 1:0. Then I need one more variable. So I. So this I is used for the iteration purpose. So this I variable also two variables. So it's a vector format 1:0. Then declare output. So wire. A comma B comma C comma D. So here initialize the input variables and output variables. So after that, write the module name while using the Verilog HDL code. So demux. So demux 1:4. So this module name I am using in the Verilog HDL code. The same name reflect here. Then demux 1:4. DUT, so device under test. Then the variables are D in selection line A comma B comma C comma T. Then initial begin. So now I am using the for loop for increasing the iterations. So before that, dump file test.vcd. So this instruction is used to simulate the Verilog HDL code. Then dump variables. Then I am using one for loop for increasing the selection line. So I equal to 0, I less than equal to 3, I equal to I plus 1. So begin the loop. So selection line equal to I. So inside I value is 0. So this 0 is assigned to selection line. So 0 represent S1 and S0 value, both the values are set to be 0. Then after 10 nanosecond. So after 10 nanosecond, change the I value. So I equal to I plus 1. So I value increment by 1. Now I value is set to be 1. So this 1 is assigned to selection line. So 1 means selection line value S1 and S0 is 0, 1. Then 2 represent 1, 0. 3 represent 1, 1. So likewise, after every 10 nanoseconds the selection line value may be change. Then n, so n this loop, then n the begin state. So once again initial, then begin. So after set the selection line, now I need to verify the result. So using the monitor statement, del monitor. So first one is data in. So data in is the binary value, and selection line also binary. Then output a value, so a also binary. Then b equal to percentage of b, c equal to percentage b, d equal to percentage b. So here all the input and output variables are declared as a binary number. Then d in comma selection comma a comma b comma c comma d. So this instruction is used to monitor the output values after changing the selection line. Then end, end module. So it's a simple test bench verilog HCL code for 1:2 DMUX. So first you write the module, then module name, declaration of input variables and output variables. Just you recall, so input variables is declared as a register and output variable declared as a wire. Then DMUX, DUT variables, just you initialize the variables. Then go to the for loop for iteration purpose. Then monitor the result, end module. I hope you understand the concept very well. If you are watching first time in my video, kindly subscribe and support us to make a lot of videos. Thank you.